Hi, hello, and welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we're going to be talking about the Femina Miss India auditions. Well, this has come on popular demand by a lot of you asking on Instagram. By the way, if you don't follow me on Instagram, you should right now. So in this video, I'm going to take you through the different steps to apply for the auditions of Femina Miss India, since Femina Miss India 2023 is coming very soon. And at the same time, in the end of this video, I'm going to give you a few tips and tricks on how to make the best out of your audition so you have a great chance at making it all the way through. So if you're interested in that, please stay tuned. So the first and the most important thing is for you to follow the Miss India org page on Instagram, and they give you all the updates regarding their upcoming auditions in that. And you have to go to the link in their bio and then register. So the main thing that they look at are three videos, the first one being your introduction video, then your ramp walk video, and then your talent round video. You are supposed to upload these on the sponsor that they have, the digital sponsor. This time it was Moj, so we had to upload these videos in Moj. And this is what my videos looked like. A 23-year-old MBA graduate currently working as a consultant with an IT firm. Coming from an army background and having lived across the country has taught me a lot about discipline, diversity, and acceptance. I was 3 years old when I first went up on a stage to perform, and my love for exploring forms of art has grown exponentially ever since. My life mostly revolved around academics and curriculars, but there was a constant feeling of unsettlement, like I was meant for something more. And when I visited Vidyotama, an orphanage, is when I realized what it was, a purpose. Ever since, I have enthusiastically volunteered to uplift and empower the disadvantaged. And through Miss India and its fabulous platform, I look forward to aligning my passion with my purpose. Thank you. On the app that they've asked for, you then are supposed to copy these links and paste it on the form which will be given on their website. And along with the link that you paste, you're also supposed to put in like your basic details regarding, you know, your name, age, documents. Three pictures will be asked for: your close-up, your mid-shot, and your full-length. And this year they also introduced a no makeup photo because they wanted to see how you look like without any makeup and all of the glam. And there are other eligibility criterias. For example, you become eligible from states, and this is specifically in terms of Miss India, you become eligible from states that you were either born in, that you are living in, and that your parents are from. So if these are three different states, then you have three different states that you can audition from. So good for you. Then the forms close after a while, and then within 10 days after the forms close, you get to know the top 10 from each state. And if some states have a lot of competition, then there are 16 girls, or some states even have 20 girls that get shortlisted. I got shortlisted from Karnataka because that was my priority state. That's the state I ideally wanted to audition from. But I was also eligible from Punjab because I was born there. Then what happens is all these girls are then called to Mumbai for a physical audition. So you have like a jury that sits and you get to speak to them in person and show yourself in person, something that was not happening because of COVID, but they restarted. So this was a little bit of a change, you know, you go along with how times change, and to, of course, your flights and your stay has to be taken care by yourself, and you're added to a group, and in that group the contestant managers send across an Excel sheet which has a lot of things like your detailed information regarding your education and your achievements and your goals and aspirations, and this is like a tabular thing that you have to fill. And then on the days of the auditions, this time the auditions were divided in 3 days. The first one was the South Zone, and then there was North and West, and then there was East, I suppose. So I had to stay for 2 days because I was auditioning for South as well as North, which was the next day. Yeah, and then you go to Times Tower. You have different call times based on when your states are going to be called into the hall. Karnataka this time had, I think, 10 were the listed ones, and then there were another 10 or 12 that were eligible from other states for Karnataka. So we were made to go sometimes 10 at a stretch, sometimes 3 at a stretch. You get to speak and give your introduction. Then they see how you walk, and then you just stand there while they evaluate you amongst other contestants and then give you points and stuff. And then they ask a few questions to a few people. Not everybody gets asked. I was not asked a single question during my Karnataka audition. You're just told that, you know, it's just some of them, they want to know a little more about that probably was not enough from their introduction or so, which also is a reason you need to make your introduction very concise and to the point, so that it pretty much explains everything about you. On the day of my Punjab auditions, which was my second day, I actually went and I was told that since you already introduced yourself on day one, you would not be speaking because you'd be cutting in time, and then, you know, the judges have already seen you and they've kind of marked you. So I was just supposed to go there and stand. So I just, Punjab had 15 girls, 10 from the top 10 and 5 who were eligible from other states like me. So I just went there and I stood. And that was the day I was asked almost all the questions. Like, everything was asked to me. I know a few of you very curious about the kind of questions that are asked, but they're very basic and they come from the tabular data that I told you that you fill before you are called for the auditions in that Excel. So it's very important what you fill in because they have that along with a photo of yours that you have submitted. So very important that your photo is there, and because they'll be looking at the photo and they'll be looking at you. So it shouldn't be like poles apart, but at the same time, it should be, you know, in the sense, it should look like you know how to face the camera. So it's important that way. I was asked plenty of questions. Some of them were political, like I was asked about the farmers bill because it was Punjab. I was asked things from, like, randomly on the spot things like, you know, if you had to pick anybody, any three people from the entire jury, who would you pick to take on a vacation and stuff like that. So you've got to be very quick and on your feet. You've got to stick to your point. You've got to just, this is where your personality really shines through. If they do want to ask you questions, it mostly means that they're interested. So I kind of started to get a hint by the end of the Punjab audition that I might make it through Punjab. It was like a very strong hunch. Then you wait for another 10 days, and that is such a stressful moment in your life because you're done with your auditions and then you're crossing your fingers. And then you start to, you know, you start to hear from pageant pages that, you know, oh, that person got a call, or the North Zone got finalized, or the South Zone got finalized, this one got from Karnataka, this one got from this, have you gotten a call yet? And I'd be like, no, it was a very, very pressurizing situation, honestly. And I think by the end I'd given up hopes because I had not gotten a call. And I was like, great, you know what, it's not gonna work out. This is like a next level stress because you've been working for it for so long and you almost made it by, you know, being called physically for auditions, and you've done so much and you're just, damn it, like, I'm like, oh, I just want to be like, I just want to make it. But then I did get a call one day before the actual announcement, and I was told that, you know, congratulations, you made it from Punjab and stuff, and we have a few documents that you have to fill. And yeah, and then you say thank you, you get a mail, and then you cry because it's like a dream come true, right? And like, you worked so hard for it, and you almost just, you make it, then you become a state finalist, and there's a title that's gonna stay with you for the rest of your life. And yeah, I mean, it's a great feeling. Wow, I'm tearing up. Alright, so here are some tips that I would like to give you to make this audition process a lot smoother for you. Things that I wish I was told. Something that I did that actually really worked in my favor was to plan my outfit and the song for my ramp walk, because ramp walk is really important. What the pageant pages catch you and kind of get you into the eyes of the organization, because they constantly keep tagging the organization and stuff, is your ramp walk videos. Because mostly pageants are about, you know, those on stage performances, so your walk is really important. So make sure you have a really nice, well fitted, something that flatters your body type. And if you don't want to go with black, you can go with another color, but like, make sure, like, I went with a lavender, which kind of looked pink, but point being that I knew that was my color, so I went for it. And make sure you know what you're doing. You know, it's very different when you train for actual ramp and when you train for the camera, because you're constantly supposed to be looking at the camera. You can't look left and right. They don't want to see how you have audience grasping power. They want to see how you do in front of the camera, because it's a virtual audition, right? So keep that in mind. Talent video will also be really, really helpful, because talent is not something that everybody has. So I rented my outfit, and like, I learned, I joined 2-3 choreographers. Some from YouTube, some by myself, and just put up a choreography which I knew I would look really good doing in the dance video. And your introduction actually is very, very important. That's where people really get to know you. You could be super beautiful, but like, if you can't speak, you know, you can rewind this video to see the introduction that I had made. So you know, just get an idea. Don't ever copy anybody's introduction, no matter how relatable you feel that person is, and you feel like, hey, I have the same goals and aspirations, I have the same background, why don't I take the same introduction? Don't do that. You might end up copying somebody who is like, who had participated around 10 years ago, thinking nobody will remember, but you have no idea. These pageant enthusiasts and these pageant pages are very, very smart. Also, make sure that your introduction, starting with your namaste or your hi, hello, till the thank you, fits in that 1 minute, because if anything gets cut, it just feels incomplete. So make sure whatever you're saying with the pauses comes in that 1 minute, because that's all you get for your introduction. Your photos are extremely important. Please make sure that you can look at all of the previous winners' ke photos. Nothing extravagant. They don't want you standing in a gown and stuff. Ideally, have body hugging clothes. Look at Miss World ke pictures, you know, their contestants, how their photographs are done. What is their close up? What is their mid shot? What is their full length? Try to, you know, do your trial and error with photographers. Like, get a good, these pictures actually really matter. So just make sure that you do these photo shoots and keep them in your hand. For the physical auditions, just make sure you have a great little black dress. Not too long, not too short, not too deep. Don't do any of the frills and stuff they will ask you to change. Don't wear velvet. I wore a velvet black dress for my Karnataka auditions. I used to wear those for a lot of tiny pageants that I used to do back in college. But for some reason, when you see other girls, you will feel like, you know, you just somehow, nothing's really like, I don't know, something about black velvet dresses just don't go when everybody else is not wearing a velvet. practice beforehand what kind of waves look good on you, what partition of hair looks good on you. They don't allow for extremely varied colors of lenses, so make sure the lenses that you wear, even if you want to wear a colored lens, it's very close to the natural eye color that you have. Your makeup can't be too cakey, keep it light. They're gonna look at you up close, they're gonna tell you to hold your hair up and like give your profiles and stuff, so be ready for things like that, you know. Just be ready for like anything that could be asked for you on spot. You could very well be asked to dance and stuff, so just be prepared. Okay, this is another tip that's gonna come in handy. I know that you're not a state finalist already and you're just going for auditions, but at that point of time as well, please do your research as to what you're getting into. There was a video that was put up as a behind the scenes of auditions where random girls, while they were getting their makeup done and stuff, you know, the camera would come up to you and ask you, you know, which year did Juhi Chawla win, or how many Miss Worlds does Miss India have and stuff like that, and you kind of get it wrong, and they were like not welcome by a lot of pageant pages because they were like, this is basic information that you need to know for the title that you're trying to hold. I just read up a little bit, it's basic research, it'll actually lead you to a lot more things. So make sure that your research is on point before you go into the audition. Research about the jury members, it's very important. I wish I'd known this earlier. Research about who the head of Miss India is, who is the head of Times of India, who is the head of Times Talent. See if you can follow them, see what kind of work that they do, you know, their background, who the winners are, the top three winners, what they like, you know. It's very important because in the jury, that's them, they are the ones asking you questions. So the more you know about who is, you're gonna stop feeling very intimidated and lost because you've done your research. Next tip is network with the girls. You will be amused by the people that you're surrounded with. There'll be some very accomplished influencers, there will be content creators, there will be actresses, there'll be people you'll be like, oh my god, I've seen her on TV. So yeah, it's gonna be like a great crowd because Miss India just happens to drive a lot of those. I remember reaching out to one of the girls who I actually had been following, a fashion influencer, for like 2-3 years. I went up to her and I told her, I know you don't know me, but I'm such a huge fan. And she was like, oh my god, thank you. I said, I love what you wear and I love what you make, you know, in your on your Instagram. And yeah, just it's gonna be a great space. A lot of the girls that I met during auditions are still very close to me and are still great friends with me, and I love talking to them. So yeah, you're gonna make great connections, so just make sure you're not in your bubble and like super stressed about how it went or how it will go and what they asked and, you know, how you're looking, and just try to, like, you know, your preparation was till this date, so stop stressing about it. Now whatever you do, it's not in your hands, so stressing is not gonna help at all. So just like relax, just enjoy the moment, you know, meet the girls, be the sunshine that they are looking for, because it's a stressful environment, but you can make it light by being yourself. And my final tip is, don't let one day break your heart. Talking out of personal experience, the first day were my Karnataka auditions, I just didn't feel like I was given any attention, and it was sad, and I had a really, really bad day, and it took so much energy out of me to pull myself back up and go the next day. I honestly just considered going home instead, but I was like, you know what, no, just get yourself together, Lake, it's just one more day, you don't even have to speak, just go and stand there with the prettiest smile that you have. And that was the day that I was asked the most questions. I was asked to introduce myself, and so don't be caught off guard like that. And even if none of the auditions go well, you made it that far, you know, like, it does not matter, really. This is just something that you're doing so you don't regret it later on. Don't let this break your heart, don't let this ruin your mood like for really long, because honestly there is a great life outside of it. As much as, I mean, I know you might say, oh, what do you know, Lake? You became a state winner. But I do know, okay? I do know, if I hadn't made it as a state winner, of course, that I would be like really sad and stuff. But like, you still, what you can still kind of venture into the modeling world and will pretty much hold the same importance as a state winner. Just saying, you know, I'm a model now, and I'm, there's not a lot of difference. It's just a few months of hype and a few experiences that you might miss out on, but you can always make it up in some way or the other. Pageants are not your life. Please don't consider them as one, okay? I hope this video was helpful. If there's anything else you want to know about the upcoming auditions or the audition, put it in the comment below. I do read the comments, I heart them, and I will respond to them. Up until then, I want you to like this video. Please share this video with friends who might need it. Comment if there's anything you liked or if there's anything you want to know. And please subscribe to my channel. We're so close to hitting 600 subscribers. It's a big deal for me, okay? Because you know, YouTube is hard, but I mean, it's you guys that keep me going. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time. Bye bye.